Open an image in Affinity Photo and go over to the gradient tool. I'm going to add a gradient to this. However, when you do that, you can't go back and change it later. This is one big problem with Affinity Photo. There's an option, so if I just go here and apply the gradient, I can manipulate the gradient. However, you can't see the image. Completely useless in that sense. You've just lost the image. Of course, what you can do, you can always go to layer and you can then fade, create, fill. So it's not ideal. So you can manipulate it that way. Just fade it using blending modes like that and then click apply. A better option would be if I go back and I've got this image now, what I can do, I can always go to layer and new layer. And now with that new layer, I can add the gradient to that. And of course I can change gradient. I can add additional stops. So I can manipulate it here or there. And I'm to say, go to that one, maybe make that red. And you can see the design change. Of course, you can't see the underlying image, but of course, because it's a layer, you can go over here and you can say darken, go through color dodge, overlay, etc. So you can apply and modify it that way. But still, you've got the same problem. So if I go over here with the layer and say I'm working on other things, doing other things, and then I come back to this one, and then I go to the gradient tool and then add the gradient again, you can see you've lost that gradient. You've created that gradient, but you haven't got it anymore. Well, the solution is for that one, so I'm just going to remove that. You've got that background image again. Go to layer and down to new fill layer. So with new fill layer, and you of course get a completely blank one there. It's a solid color start point, but you can go to linear and you can add your gradient then. And you can manipulate this gradient. You can again, just go over here, say, just add some stops. Let's just again go for say blue and maybe orange or etc. So you've got something like that. And then you can go to the blend modes. So you can go here and you can say darken. So you can see you've now got a lovely colourful design, which you can manipulate. You can still continue to manipulate, still live. So you can just tweak it. You go up here and you can say elliptical and so on. So if you decide, you know what, I want that to be the centre point. And I've got this lovely colour blue design like that. And of course you can modify the gradient, manipulate it. And also you've got other options here. You've got bitmap as well, which is even more useful in some ways. So you've got, but now, say if I just go off that layer and say, you know what, later I want to change it again. I can always go back to that layer. And you can see as soon as you do that, you get this control back. And so you can say, you know what, I don't want it on that building. I want it on that building. So you can move it around, you can manipulate the position. You can change the stops again, you can still manipulate that, change the midpoints, maybe create something like that. So the fill layer is a much better approach if you want to actually manipulate the gradient at a later point. But you can still do it layers if you want to approach it that way. But that's a way of doing that. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.